there was a Canadian consul. He told me, where do you want to be in Canada? And I said, any big city, because I'm from Damascus, it's a city of millions. He said, what do you mean? I said, just put me anywhere in the MTV. And the MTV for me were Montreal, Toronto, and Vancouver. He said, no, I'm not going to put you in the MTV. I said, where are you going to put me? He said, just, it would be a surprise, but it would be like a small town. A small town. I said, okay, small town near Toronto. He said, no, not near Toronto. So I headed to the airport at that day, and on the way to the airport, I was practicing what I learned online of being Canadian. And I was like saying, loony, toony, double, double. These are beautiful things. So this is the first thing I really learned, even in the embassy. That's the first thing they tell you, loony, toony, double, double. You have to practice. I was like, is that the national anthem? I said, no. It's all Canada. I was like practicing all of that beautiful stuff. I knew I'm going to a country where there are the most warm-hearted people on the planet. And after every country on earth closed the door for us, I was looking for any place so my family can go and my siblings can be in schools again. I was alone at that time. My flight was from Beirut to Toronto. And I told my father, you are following me for sure. It's like 2 to 3 weeks to get your visas. He said, well, that's great. So I was in the airport waiting to fly and leave the Middle East. And there was a Syrian man there. He looked so weird. He was so afraid and so scared. He was like, I can't travel. I said, why? He said, I don't speak any language other than Arabic. How am I going to survive in Toronto when we arrive there? I said, well, you can just go on YouTube and learn how to speak English. He said, well, I have 14 hours on the flight. Is that enough? I said, yes, that could be enough. So he went to YouTube. And my friend, he chose some wrong videos. The wrong videos I mean by that is a tutor on YouTube was in Spain. And he was teaching him some English. And, you know, he was telling him, if you want to start a conversation with an English speaker, always talk about the weather. And there was that sentence that my friend picked from this whole conversation. It was an hour and a half video on YouTube. And the only sentence that my friend said from that video was, if you want to start a conversation, go to an English speaker and say, hello, sir, it's a beautiful weather out there. And then the person would say, oh, that's lovely, yeah. But what's your name? And then you'd say, my name is something. And then the conversation would go on, and that's how we open connections. Because my friend said, if it's not working, go networking. That's the rule. If it's not working, go networking. That was lovely, but he picked the wrong videos. Anyway, we were on the plane from Beirut to Toronto. 14 hours, my friend was sitting beside me, and he was repeating that sentence. Hello, sir, it's a beautiful weather out there. Hello, sir, it's a beautiful weather out there. 14 hours. Imagine having that friend sitting beside you for 14 hours, saying only one sentence. Thank God we arrived in Toronto finally. Thank God. And it was minus 25 out there. It was December 18th. The first coldest night in the winter. So we landed. I was the first actually to land from the plane. I felt like everyone was shaking my hand when I landed. They were saying, welcome to Canada, welcome to Canada. Everyone was excited. I felt like I'm the Prime Minister for only that day. And my friend was with me. We did the interview with the Canadian Border Service Agency. And we were sitting there with that lovely officer. And he was saying, oh, that's great. So you are staying in Toronto. And I thought, and yes, I'm staying in Toronto, I said to him. And my friend, he was looking at me, I said, just don't tell him anything, it's wrong. Don't tell him your sentence, it's wrong. My friend was so confident, he said, I speak English now, so I'm going to tell the officer. He looked him in the eye, he said, hello, sir, it's a beautiful weather out there. And it was minus 25, so the officer looked at him again, and he opened his eyes as big as he could. And he told him, are you serious? It's minus 25. So my friend went out of the airport for 5 minutes and came back as a frozen chicken. He took my phone, he rephrased the sentence, and then he went back to the officer. After all the interviews were done, the officer was on the way out, and he told him, hello, sir, it's a horrible weather out there.